Hello and thanks for watching Proactive New York. I'm joined by Punit Dhillon. He's the CEO at Skye Bioscience. Punit, good to speak with you again.
Great speaking with you again too, Stephen. Thanks for having me on Proactive.
It's always a pleasure. We haven't updated for quite a while and you have quite a bit of news to share. So maybe starting with the most recent, you've selected Next Pharma as the contract manufacturing organization for your phase two clinical trial material. So tell us more about that.
Yeah, thanks. Next Pharma has been a great a partner for us, and we're looking forward to working with them on our phase two development and then ongoing for the commercial kind of application of this therapy. Why they make a lot of sense for us as a manufacturing partner is really they have experience in manufacturing these types of drugs, which are preservative free, multi-dose. But importantly, one of the key things is when you're looking at developing eye drops, there's a certain types of packaging that's required. Sometimes that's single use packaging, what's referred to as blow, fill, seal packaging, or it's a multi-use in terms of eyedroppers that a lot of consumers might be familiar with. So that really suits Skye's needs. The Next Pharma has the capability of developing ophthalmic drugs. They actually work with a number of other parties, including have experience with glaucoma drugs that are sold globally. So I think it really complements our capability set, and they're the right partner for long term in terms of our production process and Skye's requirements.
So what sort of timeline do you have at this stage for phase two? When do you plan to file the IND?
Well, it's important to kind of make a distinction there between phase two and phase one. And a lot of people get confused in terms of it's in our mind at Skye. Although we've been talking about it in a sequential step, they are two independent studies. Prior to me joining the company, that was a commitment that the company had made in terms of phase one. And we had kind of the train had left the station in terms of the development need of that. Certainly for a first-time drug entering into the clinic, into humans, safety and tolerability data is critical. So we wanted to have that data package, and that's the purpose of phase one. Phase two, our timeline currently stands intact in terms of in filing our IND with the FDA before the end of the year. One of the key things that came out of our pre-IND meeting with the FDA late last year was just buttoning up all of the manufacturing parts of the drug. So this is an important step in terms of Next Pharma helping to complement that, and it gives us the comprehensive kind of clinical package and manufacturing package that we would expect that builds out a full IND.
Well, let's take a look at phase one then, because completion of the production of the phase one drug, that's been updated to early September. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, certainly a setback that we announced last week. One of the woes of having a new drug enter into the clinic for the first time is some of the challenges that come along with that. So timelines have been, in my mind and on our overall management's mind, like updated twice. And for one has been just related to the regulatory side, and we can talk about that. But the biggest setback that we had recently is has been completely outside of our control, where our manufacturing partner was hit with a cyber attack. It halted all drug production activities. Since then, they've addressed that. We've addressed and recalibrated our timelines, and that's underway now. So our manufacturing will, continue later in August, and we expect that all of our quality procedures will be completed by September, and enrollment would begin in our trial in October. So that's certainly been frustrating, but we're back on track, and we expect to enroll our phase one study quickly as possible.
And of course, you received regulatory approval for the first in-human phase one clinical study of SBI-100. That was back in late June, wasn't it?
Yeah, and that's one of the other timeline things I was trying to address in the last comment here, is that new drugs entering into the clinic for the first time have, you know, been a component of opening up unanticipated rounds of comments with the regulator. So HREC in Australia, on one hand, the company got kudos for having one of the most comprehensive packages that the agent, that the committee's ever seen. And on the other hand, it spurred clarifying questions from the committee, since it's a new class of drug and it's never been used in humans before. So we went, we submitted our HREC submission in March, and it took until June to get through four rounds of comments. But that's the trials and tribulations of clinical development. So we're really, you know, pleased that we're past the regulatory step. Now, the key thing, the gating items, getting the clinical trial material over to Australia. That's on track after we've kind of talked through our timeline. And then the rest of it is our just development execution. So phase one, we're going to continue to generate the data, push towards getting that safety and tolerability data in that healthy volunteer study. And then what's really exciting for us is moving our phase two program aggressively forward, which is where we're, again, measuring safety, but also looking at efficacy in glaucoma patients and patients that have ocular hypertension.
Punit, but before we wrap up, anything else to add about SBI 100 and the programs you're busy with?
Yeah, I mean, certainly the important thing that we're really developing here is a class of drugs that are mediated for some sort of disease improvement. Our initial pipeline or initial development focus is focused on glaucoma and hypertension, where we're trying to reduce intraocular pressure, a key risk factor in glaucoma. And the key component of where our drug is making a difference is that it's binding to a receptor site that helps to mediate a lowering of that intraocular pressure, that fluid buildup that is common. And this class of drugs is doing it from a different mechanism of action than the rest of the landscape. So that's our first proving ground in terms of showing that receptor activity. And certainly it opens up a lot more opportunities in terms of other cannabinoid derivative type of applications and targets to go after in terms of those receptors that are found in the eye for other disease modification in the ophthalmology setting.
Punit, I hope you'll keep us posted on any new developments, but thank you very much for the update today.
Thanks again, Stephen.
Punit Dhillon is CEO at Skye Bioscience.